Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to start we need to open our favorite web browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type it, because I added the link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed there on the site of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice detailed description on the best way to download and install Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict on PC. We scroll lower a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will run to play Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict on the PC. It is now obvious that we access several advantages of preferring using the emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on the button. And the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's a file to execute. What we are going to do now is to run the executable file, okay, so we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We said yes. I minimize the internet browser to find the installation software better. The installer is very simple. It contains a couple of options, install, and setup path. I am going to explain what setup path does. We simply click on it. And we note that we end up with here the path where the emulator will be put in. If we want to change this folder we are required to click on the browse option, therefore we choose another folder and install the emulator wherever we choose. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on back. And I just click install. Now, there it is. The setup begins and it is going to move forward together with the download of these megabytes that happens to be shown on the computer screen. The time you save it on your hard drive, it might possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The download rate will go faster or slower, determined by your type of connection and according to the efficiency of the emulator web servers. Today they're progressing super fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started successfully. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will advance to the right when it reaches the end, the emulator is started for the first time. In fact the emulator has been started, there for the first time. Before we continue, as you will notice, it has made a couple of icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the only one we are concerned with. At any time when we want to start Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this particular icon and therefore use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the following step, which is actually a must, and that's to access the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is started. Right here we are required to sign in. Now once we're on this page, we are required to begin doing the next step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. So we mouse click on Sign In. Now it shows Checking Info. It could once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, and so it does not move forward. If so, you may attempt to connect to your account after a few hours but it will surely probably be fixed. Now we're going to insert our email address and password. The email must be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example you can utilize the same exact email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. So that I will provide my data and I'll revisit immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, info typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us the terms of service. We are going to say yes to them all by clicking, I agree. Next, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and it will create a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play is started automatically and completely on its own. To install the app, we need to go to the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on this app icon indicated in green. Now that we are discovering the desktop of this emulator for Android, we observe that we come with here the install game option. We click or double-click on the button. Here we have got the game app. Let's press there on the install button that I'm presenting now in green color. and it will commence the software installation. Presently it should download on your desktop or laptop and install the game. It can take a bit of time or it could also be almost immediate. It all is subject to on our connection to the internet. This has just completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this particular option that I am presenting in green, in order to launch Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict for the very first time. We are now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to just click on this new Gunship Battle Crypto Conflict software icon which was created. The game app is started for the first time on your computer. Currently there we get it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume level of that emulator. It is here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. This is actually the first one. We then click on this software icon that I'm designating in green color. And the monitor is maximized, offering one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If we would like to run the application in full screen, we hit this icon. And we might at present be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen mode. To exit the complete screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we would certainly now play in normal computer screen mode. Now I am choosing to demonstrate you the computer keys mapping, which is really very interesting. That step we will be ready to play the game far more easily. The very first task is to mouse click this computer keyboard icon. It's now time to get the recommended adjustments. I'm going to leave the default settings, though if you want to improve this, you can do this without any problem. As you can see, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that the emulator is launched in the wrong language, such as, in Mandarin. And to place it in the proper language we go there to the cogwheel. And there inside of many other configurations, we just click on the language drop down. We can choose the language we need, German, Chinese, and so forth. As soon as the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, and also the Android game, the next time we launch it, will of course be in the preferred language. Now, you can find another information that we have to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail telling you that a different device has been connected with this Google account. It will check with us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Of course, we shouldn't be troubled, simply because the emulator is behaving like a Google Android electronic device. And to find which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And we browse here to the model choice. And now we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for that video user demo. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that you thought it was interesting. If so, bring it a pleasant like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, issues or ideas, let them in the comment box down below. You can even leave comments on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams every now and then, you get it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Click on any of the online videos which are usually appearing on the list of videos to watch and see you in the upcoming videos. Bye.